everybody. My name is Nicola Gore and this is Nick Hill. Today we're doing a tutorial on posts and restoration of broken down teeth. It's quite a long tutorial, so I'm going to split it to one or two sections. So today we're going to do a brief overview of when and the indications, and a couple of materials which we use for posts, and then in the future tutorials we'll do more. So Nikhil, can you just tell me what are the indications for posts?
Okay, so firstly you'd use a post and core when you don't have sufficient coronal dentine and you need to give it strength in order to put a conventional crown on top. Mm-hmm. So the indications would be for anterior teeth, the teeth that have had root canal treatment, and teeth where there isn't sufficient dentine and you need to strengthen it to put a crown on top.
Okay, that's good. And you know that there's quite a lot of different posts now on the market. But the easiest way to actually divide the posts would be direct and indirect posts. So what direct posts are you aware of?
Direct posts, so Paraphase system.
Yes, good. Which is actually here. If our cameraman could catch our direct posts. So this is a Paraphase system, which is used quite widely now. There we go. And this Paraphase system has a fiber. This is metal, and we have the fiber version, fiber post version of this as well.
Then you could get lab constructed ones, so gold or stainless steel.
So that's indirect posts, okay? So, if you're talking about direct posts, then we've got our metal posts, and also we have
composite
fiber posts, yeah? And fiber posts, again, many systems, the ones we use are Reliex posts, we use these DT light posts, which are really nice as well, and they're very light and very easy to use. So let's just stick to direct posts. When would you use a fiber post, and when do you think it's better to use metal posts?
So if you had a patient where you were going to use a post and core for an anterior tooth, or where aesthetics were important, you wouldn't want a dark crown, a dark post. Mm-hmm. So you'd want to use a composite fiber post. Mm-hmm. And also you need to consider what type of cement you're using. So fiber posts are made of composite, so they'd be better with a resin cement.
Okay.
So metal posts, not too sure, maybe using it more posteriorly.
Okay, so as we discussed, finance is one of the key things, yeah? So finance, because fiber posts can be quite expensive, so finance is one of the things to take into consideration. So that would be one thing. Secondly is obviously, where the post is going to be placed. So if it's going to be more anteriorly, then yes, I would agree with you, better to use fiber posts, especially in a high smile line patient. And if you're using like EMAX or ceramic crowns to go over it, then the last thing you want is to see a shadow of a metal underneath that. Even though you could ask your technician to change the shade of your core of your crown, but to make life easy, it's better to use a fiber post. Now, fiber posts are very easy to do, or any direct post, and their technique is quite easy. What I would suggest is that it's better always to do the root canal treatment yourself.
Yeah.
Probably best never to accept somebody else's root canal treatment, unless that root canal treatment is well sealed, you don't see any sign of leakage, and apically sound. Yeah. So can you just briefly tell me, before you put a post in, what kind of things do you look at when you look at the tooth?
So I have a checklist, so I make sure that I first examine the periodontal condition, so I do a BPE and a 6-point pocket chart.
Mm-hmm.
And then I look at the restorability of the tooth to see whether or not it's viable to put a post in core on it. And then I make sure that I always have articulated study models to check the occlusion of the patient.
Well done.
And then finally, like you said, you want to make sure that the root canal is up to the best standard, so ideally doing it yourself,
okay,
or ensuring that you've got an excellent apical coronal seal.
And so you said about articulation. So what is it specifically that you're looking at on a tooth you're going to put a post in?
firstly you need to check if there's enough space, what guidance there is it canine?
Well done, guidance. So you want to keep it free of guidance, ideally, if you can, because you don't want, last thing you want is a tooth with a post-snip to be guided on. That's very good, Rahil, so far. Is everything clear so far?
Yeah,
is there anything you want to ask?
When you're removing the GP, when you're making the post, the post preparation, what's the best way of removing the GP?
So, what do you think?
I use a gate split and a eucalyptus oil.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's more difficult because it goes quite stringy.
Yeah.
And I don't know how to.
Yeah, it wraps around it, doesn't it? Yeah. I mean, ideally you could use a reamer, or you could use a reamer to take it out, or you could use just gate split. Do you know how much millimeter of GP you leave behind?
Ideally, you should leave behind about 4 millimeters of GP from the apex, and the post should occupy roughly 2/3 of the root, and it should extend beyond the centroid of the root.
Well done, yeah. So, and beyond the bone level.
Yeah.
So it's like an anti-rotation. So this is a gate splitter, what Nick was talking about, and the best way to measure where you put in your, how much you're removing, is to put a rubber stop. So you, if you've done the root canal, you know what the working length is, correct? So can you just tell me, expand on this? So you know where the working length is, what do you do?
So you've got your corrected working length. So let's say the corrected working length is 20 millimeters. So you want 4 millimeters of GP remaining. So you measure on the gate splitting and set your rubber on to the 16 millimeters. And then you use an in and out motion to remove the GP swiftly. You don't want to put it in and then to leave it there.
What can happen?
You can get caught and the gate splitter could snap.
Yeah, it could snap from here. Then they're really difficult to get out.
Yeah.
Okay, so good. So you've removed all the GP. You've left a 4 millimeter GP at the apical third. And then you've decided, for argument's sake, to use the direct Parapost kit. So what would you do then?
I'd get my post and make sure that is at the correct length.
So this is the Parapost kit. Here, you've got all these different sizes of your Parapost drill, and all these Parapost drills have got lines on them that it will show you, indicate how much deep you want to go into the canal, and also it's got the matching impression post that's for making a temporary, and that's the replica to send to the lab to make you your cast post. Okay, and then also you will have some direct metal posts there which you could cement in after you've done your prep. Okay.
So when you work through these in order, how do you know when to stop at the right stage?
So the best thing is you feel with your drill how it's tugging against the walls of your root canal. So if there's quite a lot of dentine still, then and you can't really go further, then you probably stop there. Okay, and you could stop at that. And also look at the tooth, look at the canal on the x-ray. If it's a big canal like in a canine, then you probably could go up to the blue. If it's a small canal like your lower laterals, then you probably want to just stick to the smaller one. Okay, so you will get the feel of it, and also your radiograph and the size of the tooth will be good. If you're putting a post in the upper molar with a huge palatal canal, then you could go maybe even to red. Okay, so the key here is that you don't want to go beyond the 4 millimeter. The key here is that you want to have a good apical seal with your GP.
Yeah.
And then after that, you can then, after you've done your preparation with your kit, then you can actually put the stainless steel matching post in there and then cement it. What cement can you use?
Sorry. So there's a wide variety of cements that you can use. So we were taught to use a zinc phosphate cement, or a GIC cement, or a resin cement.
Okay. Alright, good. And then I think we've covered quite a lot on Parapost, and Nicole's getting her coughing fit now, so I think we will stop, and we'll continue on our next YouTube next time. Thank you for following us, and follow me on Dental Cosmetics on Instagram. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Bye.